My dear students, in this lecture, we are going to see one of the applications of friction, namely ladder friction. So we all know that a ladder is a device which is used for climbing or scaling on the roofs or walls. So now in this diagram, you can see a ladder which is resting on the horizontal surface. So one end of the ladder is resting on the horizontal surface like this, and the other end of the ladder is leaning against the wall. So this is the wall. So this is the wall. So the other end of the ladder is leaning against the wall. So the length of the ladder is L. So the AB is ladder. The length of the ladder is L, and the weight of the ladder is W, so which is acting at the through the center, and you have two reactions here. So RA, which is nothing but the reaction, normal reaction of the flow, and this RB is nothing but the normal reaction of the wall. So both the reactions RA and RB are acting perpendicular to the surface of contact at the points A and B. And here, since this particular ladder has a tendency to slide down, so the point A will move in this direction and the point B will come down. So because of this, the frictional force at point A, that is FA, is acting in this direction. And similarly, at point B, the frictional force is acting in the direction opposite to the direction of the movement of the ladder. Therefore, the frictional force FB is acting in this direction, which is shown here. So these are the forces acting on the ladder. So you have the self weight W, you have the reactions RA and RB, which are acting perpendicular at the surface of contact at the point A and B respectively. So since the system or the ladder is in equilibrium, so we are applying the equilibrium equations here. So first we are applying the sum of forces in x direction is equal to 0, that is summation fx equal to 0. So when you see the forces which are acting in the x direction, so you have FA and RB. Therefore FA is equal to RB. Similarly, when you apply summation fy is equal to 0. So when you see the forces acting in the y direction, so you have W, then you have RA, and you have FB. Therefore, when you apply summation FY equal to 0, you get W is equal to RA plus FB. But here in this system, if you see the number of unknowns, you have four unknowns, namely FA, FB, RA and RB. But you have only two equations, that is summation FX equal to 0 and summation FY equal to 0. Therefore, in order to solve the four unknowns, we take moments about the point. So this is the third equation we have in order to solve the unknowns. That is summation MO is equal to 0. Now let us directly move to the problem. So the first problem here is a uniform ladder of length 3.25 meter and weighing 250 Newton is placed against a smooth vertical wall with its lower end 1.25 meter from the wall. The coefficient of friction between the ladder and the floor is 0.3. What is the frictional force acting on the ladder at the point of contact between the ladder and the floor? Show that the ladder will remain in equilibrium in this position. So here the question is, you have to find the frictional force which is acting on the ladder at the point of contact between the ladder and the floor. So the other data which is given in the problem is, the length of the ladder is given, which is 3.25 meter, and weight of the ladder is 250 Newton, which is acting through the center of the ladder. And the coefficient of friction between the ladder and the floor is given, which is 0.3. And this ladder, the lower end of the ladder, is at a distance of 1.25 meter from the wall. So these are the data given in the problem. So we are asked to get the frictional force at the point of contact between the ladder and the floor. Now, so first we are getting, so the lower end of the ladder is A and the upper point of the ladder is B. And since the ladder has a tendency to move in this direction, the frictional force is acting in this direction, that is FF. And so we are getting the force RF. So we are applying this equilibrium equation, that is the sum of the forces in the vertical direction is equal to zero. So if you see the forces acting in the vertical direction, you have two forces, RF and 250. So when you apply summation FY equal to zero, so we get RF is equal to 250 Newton. And also this distance is known, that is 1.25 meter, and the length of the ladder is known, 3.25 meter. Therefore, we can get the distance BC from the geometry of the figure. So we get BC is equal to root of 3.25 square minus 1.25 square. So the length of BC is 3 meters. Now we want to get the frictional force. We are taking moment about the point B. So we start with the force FF. So FF into 3. So force into perpendicular distance. So this FF into the perpendicular distance is 3. So which is equal to, so RF into 1.25. And similarly, you have the moment of this force, that is weight of the ladder. So minus 250 into 0.625. 0.625 is nothing but the half of 1.25. So 250 into 0.625. So from this, we get the frictional forces, 52.1 Newton. Now the other question is, we have to see whether the ladder will remain in equilibrium position in this position. So in this position, we have to check whether the ladder remains in equilibrium. So for that, we are calculating the maximum frictional force. So using this equation, that is mu into RF. So RF is nothing but the normal reaction. So 0.3 into 250, that is 75 Newton. So the maximum frictional force available at the point of contact is 75 Newton. Whereas the force of friction required for equilibrium is 52.1 Newton. Therefore, since the frictional force available is greater than the frictional force required for the equilibrium, we can conclude that the ladder is in equilibrium position. Now, let us see the second problem. So here, there is a ladder which is 5 meters long. It rests on a horizontal ground and leans against a smooth vertical wall at an angle of 70 degrees with the horizontal. The weight of the ladder is 900 Newton and acts at its middle. The ladder is at the point of sliding when a man weighing 750 Newton stands on a rug 1.5 meters from the bottom of the ladder. Calculate the coefficient of friction between the ladder and the floor. So here you have a ladder. So the weight of the ladder is 900 Newton, which acts at the middle point of the ladder. And the length of the ladder is given as 5 meters. And in addition to the self weight of the ladder, you have a person weighing 750 Newton. And he is standing at a distance of 1.5 meters from the bottom of the ladder. So for under this condition, and the angle of inclination of the ladder is given as 70 degrees. So for this condition, we have to get the coefficient of friction between the ladder and the floor. And now here in this problem, the vertical wall is smooth, therefore the frictional force at the point B will be equal to zero, similar to the first problem. So now for the given forces, first we are trying to resolve the forces vertically. So if you see the forces acting in the vertical direction, so you have the normal reaction of the floor, so which is RF, and you have the weight of the ladder, which is 900 Newton, and also you have a man weighing 750 Newton. So when you resolve the forces vertically, you get RF is equal to 900 plus 750, which is 1650 Newton. So we can get the frictional force now after getting the normal reaction RF. So FF is equal to mu F into RF. So mu F into 1650. So this mu F we are going to find out. Now we are going to take moment of all the forces about the point B. So we start with RF. So RF into this distance. So this distance is nothing but 5 into sine 20. So 5 into sine 20. And similarly, we are taking the moment of this frictional force FF. So FF into this vertical distance. So this vertical distance is nothing but 5 into cos 20. Similarly, you have that 900 Newton. So 900 into the distance. So the distance is 2.5 into sin 20. So that is the distance. Similarly, 750 into 3.5 sin 20. So we have taken moment of all the forces about the point B. So from the geometry, we are calculating the distances. So from this, we get an equation like this. And for FF, we are substituting mu F into RF. So RF is nothing but 1650. So after substituting all the values of RF and FF, we get an equation like this. And we are doing some simplifications. That is, we are dividing both sides by 5 sin 20. So after dividing both sides by 5 sin 20, we get an equation like this. From this, we are getting the coefficient of friction as 0.15. But now let us see problem number 3, so which is similar to the previous problem. So here the question is, uniform ladder of 4 meter length rests against a vertical wall with which it makes an angle of 45 degree. The coefficient of friction between the ladder and the wall is 0.4 and that between the ladder and the floor is 0.5. If a man whose weight is one half of that of the ladder ascends it, how high will it be when the ladder slips? So you can see the figure here. You can see the forces acting on the ladder. So here the coefficient of friction between the ladder and the wall is also given. That means that the wall is not smooth and you have the frictional force here also. And since at this particular point, the ladder has a tendency to come down, your frictional force is acting in this direction. And then you have the Rw, which is nothing but the reaction of the wall. Then Rf is nothing but the reaction of the floor. Then FF is nothing but the free action, frictional force acting at the floor. Then you have the self weight of the ladder W. Then you have a man whose weight is half of the weight of the ladder. So it is marked as 0.5 W. So the question is, you have to find the distance X. So for that, we know that the frictional force which is acting on the floor is given by mu F into the normal reaction Rf. So mu is given as 0.5, therefore we get FF is equal to 0.5 into RF. Similarly, you can calculate the frictional force on the wall, that is FW, is equal to mu W into RW. Since mu W is given as 0.4, we are substituting here. So FW is equal to 0.4 into RW. Now we are resolving the forces vertically. So if you see the forces acting in the vertical direction, so you have RF, then you have FW, then you have W, then you have 0.5W. So when you resolve it, so we get RF plus FW is equal to W plus 0.5W, which is equal to 1.5W. So similarly, we are resolving the forces vertically. So when you see the forces acting in the vertical direction, you have RW, then you have FF. So FF is already known, that is 0.5 into RF. So we get RW is equal to FF, which is equal to 0.5 into RF, or we can get RF is equal to 2 into RW. Now we are substituting the values of RF and FW in equation 3. So after substituting those values, we get RW is equal to 0.625W. And since we know that FW is equal to 0.4 into RW, so we are substituting this also here. So we get FW is equal to 0.25W. Now, in order to get the unknowns, we are taking moment of all the forces about the point A. So when you take moment of all the forces about the point A, so you have the moment of W, that is W into 2 cos 45. Similarly, you have the moment of this particular force 0.5W, so which is 0.5W into X cos 45. So which is equal to, then you have this force RW. So RW into, you have 4 sin 45. Similarly, you have the force FW. So FW into, you have 4 cos 45. So we are taking moment of all the forces about the point A. So after taking the moment, so we get an equation like that. And in that equation, we are substituting the values of RW, that is this value, and FW. And we are doing some simplification. That is, we are dividing both sides by W sine 45, and after simplification, we got x is equal to 3 meters. Now the next problem is a uniform ladder, 3 meter long, weighs 200 newton. It is placed against a wall making an angle of 60 degree with the floor as shown in figure. The coefficient of friction between the wall and the ladder is 0.25, and that between the floor and the ladder is 0.35. The ladder, in addition to its own weight, has to support a man of 1000 newton at its top B. Calculate the horizontal force P required to ladder at the floor level to prevent slipping. And the question 2 is, if the force P is not applied, what should be the minimum inclination of the ladder with the horizontal so that there is no slipping of it with the man at its top? So here in this question, you have a ladder. The length of the ladder is 3 meter. The weight of the ladder is 200 newton. And it is placed against a wall. And the angle of inclination of the ladder with respect to horizontal is 60 degree. And the coefficients of friction are given. That is, between the wall and the ladder, it is 0.25. And between the floor and the ladder, it is 0.35. And in addition to the self weight of the ladder supports a man of 1000 newton at the top point B. So it's shown here. And the question is, you have to find the horizontal force. That is, you have to find the horizontal force P to be applied to a ladder at the floor level. So what should be the force P applied at this point in order to prevent the slipping of the ladder? So that is the first question. And the second question, suppose if this force P is not applied, then what should be the minimum inclination of the ladder in order to prevent the slipping? So you have two questions here. Now let us consider the first case, that is the horizontal force P applied at the floor level in order to prevent the slipping. So here you can see the forces acting in this ladder. So you have the applied force P, then you have the frictional force FF, you have the normal reaction RF, self weight of the ladder 200 newton, then weight of the man, which is 1000 newton, which is applied at the point B. Then you have the normal reaction of the wall, RW. You have the frictional force, FW. Now, for this case, we are resolving the forces vertically. So we get first horizontally. So we get P plus FF is equal to RW. Similarly, we are resolving the forces vertically. So when you see the vertical forces, you have RF and you have FW. You have 200 newton and you have 1000 newton. So when you apply the equation of equilibrium, we get RF plus FW is equal to 1000 plus 200, which is equal to 1200 newton. Now we are taking a moment of all the forces about the point A. So the forces to be considered are 200 newton, then 1000 newton, then you have RW, then you have FW. So we are taking moment of all these forces about the point A. So this is the moment equation we are getting, and we are dividing both sides by cos 60 degree. So after doing the simplification, we get this particular equation involving FW and RW. But we know that FW is equal to mu W into RW. Mu W is given in the problem, that is the coefficient of friction between the ladder and the wall. So that is 0.25. So we are substituting here. So we got FW is equal to 0.25 RW. Now, we are substituting this value of FW in equation 3. So after substituting the value of FW in equation 3, so we get the reaction, that is normal reaction of the wall, as 555 newton. Similarly, from this we can calculate the frictional force FW as 138.7 newton. Then after finding out this RW and FW, so we can substitute back in equation 2 to get the reaction of the floor, that is RF, and similarly FF. And from that, we can get the force required. So we got P is equal to 183.5 newton. So this is the first case. And the second case is that you don't have the horizontal force P, but instead we have to find the angle of inclination of this ladder. So in order to prevent it from slipping. So here now, if you consider the forces acting on this ladder, so you have the weight of the ladder, then you have the weight of the man, frictional force of the wall, normal reaction of the wall, frictional force of the floor, the normal reaction of the floor. So here also we are going to resolve the forces horizontally as well as vertically, and we are going to make use of the equation Fw is equal to mu w into Rw. So after applying this, we get reaction of the floor as 1101 Newton, and similarly the reaction of the wall Rw, similarly the frictional force of the wall. Now we are taking moments about A. So when you take the moment of all the forces about the point A, so about A, so the forces, if you want to take the moment of forces, you have to take moment of Fw, you have to take moment of Rw, then you have to take moment of 1000 Newton, and also you have to take moment of 200 Newton. So when you take the moments about the point A, we get this particular equation. So dividing both sides by 3 cos alpha, and after doing some simplifications, we get tan alpha is equal to this, or alpha is equal to 68.9 degrees. So students, ladder friction is one of the interesting applications of the friction. So the concept here is very simple. So we apply the simple equations of equilibrium to solve the problems on ladder friction. And for this particular lecture, I have referred the textbook of engineering mechanics by R.S. Gurney, published by S. Chand and Company Limited. Thank you so much.